Welcome to Bitcoin News today on the 8th of January 2019. There's some good news regarding the Bitcoin ETF that we've been eagerly awaiting. Both the Winklevoss twins have confirmed commitment to a Bitcoin ETF, and also Japan is gauging interest in a Bitcoin ETF and is all set to launch the first Bitcoin ETF, which is fantastic news, could be great news for the Bitcoin price. So I'm going to do some technical analysis on the Bitcoin price and try to predict what might happen next. We have seen recently volume has been going lower, and also the range, the price range, has been trading more narrowly. Now, I've done some analysis on the Bitfinex chart historically that goes all the way back. Bitfinex, because it's got a lot of volume, even though it's not an exchange that I personally use. And I found that there's certain patterns in the chart that are more reliable than others. A lot of other analysis people talk about things like the head and shoulders pattern, etc. But I've not found that those patterns are statistically credible, not for Bitcoin anyway. They might be for stocks and shares, but Bitcoin seems to behave differently. And in fact, the ones that I found most reliable are the pipe top patterns, such as this one here that we see, where we've got two little wicks that are equal lengths, normally at the top of a movement. So this is an ideal one here that we saw on the 20th of December. They have a 90% chance of reaching their target, and the next one behind that is the pivot point reversal for an uptrend. We did get one of those on the 25th of December here, where we was in an uptrend and then this red candle broke that uptrend by going downwards. So that's a pivot point reversal of a uptrend with an 84% chance of reaching its target. Then the one after that is an inside day pattern. These happen quite often, and this is where the day's trading range fits within the previous day's range. For example, we did get a lot around Christmas. For example, here this green pattern fits within the red candle previously to it. So that's the one from the 25th of December to the 26th of December. Then let's see, here is another one pretty much. This red candle more or less fits within the green candle. It's not a perfect one there. This one here on the 1st of January fits within the previous day's candle from the 31st of January. Now these have an 82.9% chance of reaching their target. And finally, the last one is the pivot point reversal of a downtrend. So very similar to the pivot point reversal uptrend. We did get one on the 28th of December. So we was in a downtrend here, and then this big green candle broke that downtrend, and they have an 80% chance of success. So in today's video, let's look at the top performing ones. Let's first of all look at this pipe top and see if we can predict where the price might go next. The pipe top pattern has a 90% chance of reaching its target with Bitcoin. And we got a breakout of this pattern. A breakout occurs when the price goes above or beyond, above or below the range of this pattern. Now, I'm not going to count this wick here, not necessarily anyway, because it was just a wick. The main body of that candle did not break the pattern, but we did break the pattern of that pipe top definitely on the 27th of December, where you see the body of the candle went below this pipe here. So we can class that as breaking the pattern in a bearish way, meaning that the price will go down. So the way that we calculate that is simply we measure the height of the pattern, which is 11.75%, and we take that off the bottom of the pattern, roughly. 11.75. So we're looking at down here at 3340. The other way of doing it is you take it off the candle that broke the pattern itself. So if we did it that way, 11% lower, it's 3257. So we're looking at the price going back to the previous lows that we were at down here, basically. So what I'll do is I'll draw a line here. It could go even lower than that, but we did get strong support here. So we're looking at the price possibly going down here. That has a 90% chance of happening, historically anyway. So the next one is the pivot point reversal uptrend from Christmas Day, the 25th of December. So here you see we were in a big uptrend. We were seeing higher lows each time. And then on Christmas Day, the price broke down. And we did break this pattern on the 27th of December, where you see that the price went even lower than the height of that pattern. So similar thing here. We measure the height of that pattern, which is 8.35%. Take it off the one that broke that pattern height, if you see what I mean. And that will take us down to about here, which is $3371. So again, I'll put a line there so we can see what that target is. So we do have two lower targets. And let's go on to the next one, which is an inside day pattern. Now, the way that I calculated my inside days, I was looking at a mixture of all of the Bitcoin prices from various different exchanges, and it might not necessarily correlate exactly to the figures from the Bitfinex exchange. So for example, I did see one on the average figures on Christmas Day, which is here, these 2 days. An inside day pattern involves two bars, or two different days of trading on the daily chart. So you see that on the 26th of December, that did fit in with the entire day from previously. It went slightly below it on the Bitfinex chart. But if we class this as being an inside day pattern, it did break that pattern downwards on the 27th of December. So let's try to figure out a target for that one. Get the height of that pattern, 7.63%, and take that off the bottom of here. Let's try that again. 7.63, which is here, very close to the previous line here. So that agrees with the other target. I won't draw another line here because it's so close to that one. So both of those patterns predict that we are going to go down to this range here that we previously saw between the say the 14th and the 16th of December. Now, we did get some other inside day patterns as well. Let's look at the 22nd of December. 22nd of December. Now, on the chart here, it was between the 21st and the 22nd of December. You'll see that this pattern here fits within the previous day. And I believe that it was on the 27th of December as well that we broke down below the height of that pattern. So let's just measure that one. The height was 9%. So let's take 9% off of this one here. 9% lower. Again, takes us down to this range. So that's another sign that the price could be dropping lower. Then on the 28th of December, let's just check for an inside day here. Yep, on the 20, between the 28th and the 29th, the price range on the 29th fitted in with the previous day's range did go slightly above on Bitfinex, but let's presume that this is a inside day pattern. It's not a perfect one. And then let's see where we broke out of that range. And it was pretty much, well, on the 6th of January we broke out of that range, and it did break out upwards, which is good news. So the height of that pattern is 10%, and if we add that on to the 6th of January, add on 10%, that takes us up to 4653. By the way, I'm using TradingView here, which is a great tool for doing chart analysis. You'll find the link to it in the video description, along with some other things that I recommend. So we're looking at an upper target here and lower targets down here. So my prediction is that most likely we will see the price go down this way, bearish, 90% chance of that. And the one that predicts that the price is going to go upwards, 82.9% chance that the price will go up to this direction as well. So let's put some other things on the chart and try to predict when these things will happen. So do bear with me. Hopefully you're finding this interesting and useful. So first of all, I'm going to put on the shorts, Bitcoin shorts, because in my experience, looking at the charts, the Bitcoin shorts do definitely affect the Bitcoin price. Okay, so you'll see this red line on the chart now, and this is people betting against the Bitcoin price increasing. So let's look at this historically. Okay, and you'll see that previously, when the Bitcoin shorts dropped to a low level, what we saw afterwards was a drop in the Bitcoin price here. On the 12th of November, we did have a big drop on the 23rd of September, which didn't necessarily affect the price, but the drop was not as severe as we are seeing now. We got a more severe drop on the 1st of September, and then shortly after, there was a big drop in price. And let's see if there's another severe drop recently. Did get one. That dropped a little bit slower, started dropping on the 10th of April to the 12th of May, and the Bitcoin price did drop there. So, seems to me, looking at the chart, that whenever we do get a big drop in the shorts, then the Bitcoin price drops afterwards. The other thing that we can look at, now I'll take that off the chart so that it doesn't cause too much confusion, hopefully, because I don't like the chart to get too messy. The other thing that we can look at is the moving averages. So on my moving averages, I've got them set up so that we've got blue and a yellow line. The blue line is the 20-day moving average. The yellow line is the 50-day moving average. So let's see if the price is respecting any of these lines. So you see from the 14th of November, it was below both of these lines, and then on the 18th of December, it crossed above the blue line, which remember is the 20-day moving average. And then since then, we've seen the price respecting the 20-day moving average. The 20-day moving average seems to be working as a support line since the 27th of December. So it might be difficult for the price to break down below this support line, and especially as we've now got the 50-day moving average below there as well. So what we could see for some time is some sideways action, perhaps. Now, the other thing that we can look at is the money flow index. The money flow index is similar to the RSI, but it's also weighted with volume. So when there's more volume, it gives that greater weight behind it. which is useful. And we can see that on the daily chart, the money flow index is increasing. So perhaps this could indicate, as well as the moving averages, that we could see the price go towards this upper target at the moment. And looking at the wicks as well on the chart, we can see that there has been some wicks on the top. This suggests that there is some resistance to get up to these levels. But we've also seen wicks on the bottom as well that suggest there's good support at these levels down here. Let's draw these as some boxes on the chart. So we can see here there is some resistance in these levels. And down here as well, we can also see that there is support as these wicks have, we've seen rejection basically. Whenever the price has gone into these zones, it's been rejected. So we're currently in a very narrow trading range. So hope this information is useful. I'm sorry I can't tell you exactly what is going to happen next, but the money flow index looks like it is on the way up. So that could suggest that we could see the price trying to break through this resistance level in the next few days. If this video is useful for you, definitely click the thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel, and let me know what you think will happen. I'd love to hear your predictions in the comments below. Also, check out this video that I know you will love, and in the description of the video you can get $10 worth of Bitcoin for free as a gift from me and Coinbase as a thank you for watching. See you again soon. Bye for now.